Hello.
Hi. Welcome to the Retro Shed once again. Thank you very much for joining us. And we've had a lot of new subscribers in 1 week. Well, for us, we have
2 weeks.
Yeah.
2 weeks. How many have we had? 58. So thank you very much, and a warm welcome to all the people that have found us.
Yeah.
Hopefully you'll stick with us. We don't drive you mad, because he drives me mad.
And well, he drives me mad.
We drive each other mad, yeah, so we'll probably end up driving you mad.
Yeah.
But thanks for all the messages as well. We had some great messages this week from all over the world.
And we read every single one of them.
Alaska, it's Canada, crazy. Florida. So hi, you lot. Thank you for joining us. We do read every single message, and we appreciate every single last one of you guys. So you can also interact with us on
Facebook,
Faceache,
yeah,
Twitter. Yeah. So look us up on Facebook and Twitter and say hello and give us ideas, because we run out of them very quickly.
We always like hearing it, don't we?
We do, yeah. So. Now, this week I was been thinking.
Oh.
Again.
Oh dear.
I'm reading Ready Player One at the moment, which you all know is going to be, hopefully, is going to be an epic movie.
Can't wait.
Released March this year. The trailer does absolutely look brilliant.
Yeah.
And directed by Uncle Spielberg. I can't think of anyone better to direct
a retro theme.
What he is like, he's like Uncle George Lucas and Uncle Spielberg.
Why do you call him Uncle?
I don't know. And also been watching Stranger Things, and I noticed something about Stranger Things and Ready Player One.
In season two.
They both mention Dig Dug.
Yay.
And of course, this got me thinking, and we thought today we might have a look at the differences between the two, because they are both classic games.
Mm-hmm. You forgot to mention Mr. Do there.
Mr. Do and Dig Dug, yes, or Doug Do or whatever it's called.
Doug Do and Mr. Dug.
I keep getting the names right.
Mr. Dig or Mr. Do.
How many times did I get the name wrong?
Dig Do.
We'll get there eventually.
Between the years of 1978 and 1983, prior to the decline in video games, most people tend to think of this as the golden age of video games.
Yeah, it was.
When the technology was fairly new and there were some iconic and brilliant arcade games being made.
There were, yeah. A lot of people actually consider 1982 to be the best year in video arcade gaming. Okay, yes, there were tons of excellent games created after this period, as we know, as Outrun in 1985 and so on. But 1982 was very special indeed. So, here's a question. What do you guys know about 1982?
Let's consider. Yeah. None of us were born then.
I was.
So, I mean,
you were.
I'm trying to compliment you, Baz. neither of us were born then, so not a lot, really. Only kind of what we've learned over the years.
With you.
So, yeah.
But speak for yourself. I know quite a bit about 1982, actually.
Okay, go on.
Ready?
Yeah.
Well.
Oh, bless you.
Well, as I knew we were looking at Dig Dug, I think the whole shed just shook them. As we were looking at Dig Dug, I went and looked some stuff up. Did you know? I'm good. Top movie of 1982 was Blade Runner.
Yeah.
E.T., The Fink, First Blood, and Conan the Barbarian were also released in 1982.
Right, okay.
Mm-hmm. And Come On Eileen, Eye of the Tiger, Fame, The Lion Sleeps Tonight, House of Fun, and Golden Brown were some of the top tunes in 1982.
Nice.
Izzy's going to have to come back with something then.
Okay, how about this then?
Go on, then.
Top arcade games of 1982 are...
Yeah.
We've got Zaxxon.
Yeah.
Miss Pac-Man.
Oh.
Pole Position.
Brilliant.
Donkey Kong Jr.
Oh.
Yeah.
Jungle Hunt, Pengo, Time Pilot, Popeye.
Remember Popeye? Yeah.
My teacher's got a hoodie with Popeye on it.
Oh, really? It's awesome.
What's the game?
Yeah, no, she's got a bright red hoodie. She wore it to my trip. She had a bright red hoodie with a picture of Popeye doing that.
Cool. You got a cool teacher there.
Yep. We've got Joust, we've got RoboCharm, and of course, Dig Dug and Mr. Do.
Incidentally, Joust is featured very heavily in Ready Player One as well.
There's
a Joust challenge, as you probably see. It's very good, actually. I'm proud of you guys.
Thanks.
The arcade business in the US alone is worth over $4.3 billion. And in today's money, that's around about $11 billion. So it was a very big industry.
Yeah.
Some of those games you mentioned are absolute classics today. I mean, RoboTron, a game. Jeff Minter had did a version of that called Llamatron.
Oh.
Where you control a llama. She's absolutely brilliant.
Awesome.
Whatever. But the two we're most interested today are two very similar underground digging monster
killing
games,
gear.
Dig Dug and Mr. Do. I think I was 10 when these were released in 1982. Oof.
But you see, I've only recently started watching Stranger Things, but I love the video arcade scene in the second season and watching the guys playing Dragon's Lair and shouting at each other.
They got as angry as you do playing games.
And then he swears and boots the machine. And like, let's be honest, I don't swear and throw the controller and then kick the Xbox, do I? Like Dustin.
No.
Overpriced bullshit, son of a bitch, piece of shit.
You're just not nimble enough, but you'll get there one day. But until then, Princess Daphne is still mine.
You know, whatever. I'm still top on Centipede and Dig Dug.
You sure about that?
Sure about what? Okay, no, 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 no. Oh, oh. Oh, no, 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 no,
no,
no, no!
751,300 points.
That's impossible.
Who's Mad Max?
Better than you.
Is it you?
You know I despise Dig Dug.
And seeing all those other classic games made me just want to be there. And I have come to an amazing conclusion.
Okay.
What's that then?
You had me a few decades early. I wanted to experience the 80s, damn it!
Well, all I can say is if I had a TARDIS, I'd take you back to the 80s. In fact, if I had a TARDIS, I'd take myself back to the 80s.
Yeah.
Because it was probably the coolest era, the coolest decade.
Oh, yeah,
for music, awesome. For games.
For everything.
It was just
everything.
Brilliant, yeah. So, yeah, you're right. I did have you a few decades too early. And
you
I'm
did.
Really sorry
yeah.
about that,
but,
Josh,
for you to have been alive in the 80s would mean Dad would have had to have been...
That's a scary thought. Either. Let's not do that. No, let's leave it.
Moving
there.
On,
you
yeah.
Know,
anyway.
Do you know, I do feel for you, Josh. Yes, you have some. Well, we all have amazing games and technology today.
PS4,
yeah.
Xbox One.
And I know, yeah, people must think I'm a grumpy old fella going on about when I was younger. But the 80s
but
really
do.
Did rock.
Oh,
and I do
yeah.
miss reading Ready Player One.
get it right.
Getting my words out. Makes me remember a lot about the 80s and the whole era of going to cafes and chip shops and thinking,
just spending
what
ages
game is
playing
that in the corner?
Yeah,
yeah,
you
to
just
buy
don't
a bag
get
of
that
chips,
anymore.
Yeah. Come out an hour and a half later after being on Gallagher for hours. But yeah, it was a great time. It really was.
Okay, well, before you get all misty-eyed about the 80s, come on. Let's look at these two games in more detail because they really are quite similar, aren't they?
Yeah.
So some would go as far to say that Universal, the company that made Mr. Do, just kind of went and ripped off Dig Dug a little bit after seeing the game before its release.
No!
And you can!
No. Game companies copying each other and producing the same game but under a different name.
No,
I've never heard
no.
that.
Silly me.
I won't
nope.
hear of such
no.
nonsense.
No.
Challenge everything!
Now, these two games have been compared to each other a lot over the years, and there's a strong division between fans as to which is the best. Mm. So, what's the deal on that?
What did you call me?
Dad.
I could have sworn you called me.
No,
something.
He called you Dad.
Did he?
Yeah.
You just watch yourself. I have this death sentence on 12 systems.
I'll be careful.
You'll be dead.
So for those of you who have never seen Dig Dug or Mr. Do...
You shouldn't be watching
this
video.
Watching this video. What we have here are two great arcade games that were released in April 1982 and October 1982, respectively, 6 months apart.
Yeah.
Now, Dig Dug was developed by the awesome Namco, who are well known for games such as Pac-Man, Galaxians, Galaga.
Which I beat you at.
Moving on. And Mr. Do was developed by Universal Entertainment Corporation, who were best known for... Mr.
Well,
Do, really?
Yeah, not really much else.
Right, let's kick off with Dig Dug, as it is my favourite, and it was made first.
Okay.
Dig Dug was developed by Namco and published outside of Japan by Atari Corporation.
Yeah.
So you play Dig Dug, a chap in some kind of protective suit, under a bicycle pump, who digs tunnels through the ground looking for monsters. When he finds the monsters, he can pump them full of air, and then they explode.
Who comes up with this
I know.
Stuff?
I would like to know what they were thinking when they thought, that sounds like a good game. But to be honest, it could happen, right?
I don't know.
It could. You never know. There happens to be two races of underground dwelling monsters in Dig Dug. You've got the Pookas, which
are
so cute.
The Pookas.
They're kind of like a cute tomato with yellow goggles and Thygars. Mm. Which,
who are just mean.
Yeah, they're a race of fire breathing, green, scary, angry dragons.
From Wales.
Yeah.
Why are they from Wales?
Both of them are out to kill Mr. Dig Dug. Poor Mr. Dig Dug.
I know, everyone's out to kill him.
Yeah. As well as the monsters, Dig Dug can be killed by falling rocks and the Thygar's fire.
Which
as
I
well.
Forgot.
Yeah. You did, didn't
I
you?
I forgot.
Yeah.
Yes, you did, as you'll find out. A monster can be killed by falling rocks or three pumps of Dig Dug's pump until they explode. Now, you can actually partially inflate one of these monsters that stuns it for a few seconds.
Yeah.
And this allows Dig Dug to pass through the monster unharmed.
But they do deflate.
A stunned monster cannot move, and experienced players use this to their advantage to get out of sticky situations, unlike me. And they also use the rocks to drop rocks onto the stunned monsters.
Yeah,
so it's a good strategy.
Dig Dug and monsters move horizontally horizontally and vertically for the tunnels in the dirt, and they can also turn into ghostly eyes, which slows their movement but allows them to travel diagonally through the dirt.
Yeah, so dangerous.
The last remaining ones on any level will try leg it to the surface. They'll try and fly up and get it to the left hand corner.
You get that panic music, don't you? Yeah, well.
They're like, no, get this, I'm going, bye.
It goes like panic music.
Now what Barry's good at is points. So points can be earned for killing monsters deeper down in the dirt. So each screen has different coloured levels to represent the deeper levels. And the lower down you kill them, you get extra points.
Yeah.
And also by dropping rocks on them as well, you get extra points.
Yeah, which is the best bonus. The best way of playing the game, actually. Use the rocks.
Yeah.
After a player kills enemies with two rocks, a bonus item appears, and they're normally fruits and vegetables and weird stuff like that.
Nothing you'd actually want.
No. Sometimes a Galaxian flagship appears, which I would want.
Yes.
But I've never actually seen that.
Have you not?
I've never
Galaxian
seen the Galaxian
flagship.
Yeah, the little flagship, the little ship that you play in Galaxian sometimes appears as a bonus. I've never seen it. Incidentally, actually, did you know that the arcade cabinet version of Dig Dug runs on the same hardware as the Galaga machine?
I did on that. So, the arcade version of the game finishes at level 256.
Wow. Yeah.
Which is an unplayable screen.
Oh.
As where Dig Dug spawns in, a Pooka is placed directly on top of him.
That's not very fair.
No, not very fair. Yeah, you're right. Now, Namco gave the character the original name of Dig Dug, but in other games where he makes an appearance, he goes by the name of Taizo Hori.
Taizo Hori.
Taizo Hori.
How strange.
Well, Dig Dug has literally been ported to almost every 8-bit home computer and console ever, and versions exist for Atari 2600, Atari 5200, Atari 7800, Intellivision, Apple II, all the Atari 8-bit computers, VIC-20, C64, IBM PC, IBM PC, and Texas Instruments TI-99. Now, a Game Boy version was released in 1992 with a choice of new and original versions of the game.
Yeah.
Versions are available for NES, Xbox, and PlayStation.
As spoke of previously, an episode of Stranger Things Season 2 features the game Dig Dug, and it has an entire episode named after it.
Yeah.
And there's also mentions of the game in the book Ready Player One by Ernest Cline.
Yeah.
So this game will certainly go down in history as one of the memorable 80s arcade games ever.
It certainly will.
So, should we take a look at it?
Let's play Dig Dug, and let's not fall out over it, okay?
No. What's this one?
This is Dig Dug.
Yeah. Got to make sure you're aware.
Yeah. Dug Dig or...
Yes, or Dug Do.
Do Dig.
Dig Dig Do.
Let's see how good Izzy is.
Right, Izzy's playing. Now, we have been... Josh has been practicing this over the past few minutes. And he's quite good at it, actually.
I prefer this over Mr. Do.
Do you?
I just do. I've always...
You just do. Oh, dear. Yes. No chance. Oh. Oh, look at that.
Don't forget, the lower down the level you kill them, the more points you get.
Do you?
Yeah, that's what these banded areas are for. So if you kill him down there, and you get much better bonuses for killing them with rocks.
Yeah, that's waiting for him to come up the top.
Yeah.
I'm wary of that guy and when he's going to decide to go. Like that.
He's going for it.
Go back up top.
Oh, I'm going to have to.
He's
going to
leg
it
to the top left.
He's going
to... Just wait there. That's it. You got him.
Yes. No chance. I knew thought I'd be terrible at this game.
So, Josh, you've been playing this game since you were how old?
Four.
Yeah. Because we had the little Namco joystick thing, didn't we?
Yeah.
Oh,
you
no.
You can't do that.
I'll do that.
Oh, I got too close. I got too cocky, didn't I?
Cheating, man. You can't do that. Cheating.
Right, I'll have you.
I love the way these first three levels are really simple, and then suddenly, watch, you don't breathe fire on you.
Yes.
You can always tell when they're about to breathe fire because his ears start to flash, I think.
Oh.
You get a couple of flashes of his head, and then he'll breathe fire.
Where am I? Oh, I'm there. I thought it was one of the bad guys then.
So did I.
I like to take risks. I live on the edge. Oh, no. Oh, I don't. I like the panic music, but I don't at the same time because it makes me panic. Oh, he's gonna go.
He's going for it. Just wait there. You got him.
Yeah. He has no idea. And then poof.
Surprise!
Do. Oh, I like this. I can play this for
a
while.
We're starting to get busy.
Oh, yeah.
And some of those chambers have two pukas in as well at the same time.
Pukas!
That's when you get to round seven.
And that's when you get to, it starts to get very dangerous.
It's quite good how you can, your string's quite long.
Your pump?
Yeah. Oh no! No, no, no! Oh, that.
Well, I don't know, Josh.
Didn't
dunno.
Panic.
I could be them.
You reckon?
Bass, I could have gone on for a lot longer, but you stopped
me. Yeah, you
me.
Could, I know.
Ah. Oh.
Keep the game.
Would have got away with it if you hadn't stopped me.
Those meddling kids. Oh, no. Such a sore loser, aren't you?
No, I mean, I've beaten you. That's what I'm happy about.
Okay.
Right, my turn.
So he's about to get his comeuppance because I will beat him at this point. Doesn't matter what score he gets, I will beat him.
No, you won't.
I will.
You won't.
I will.
You won't.
Just watch.
You won't. Mate, I'm a master of bingo. Which tools are you going for?
Oh, dear.
Shite.
Oh, we spoke the cursed words.
Josh has just dropped a rock on his head.
Whoa, you...
Oh,
oh dear.
You still have a gun.
Oh.
Can I wait for one of them to move?
If they go, if oh. they both go... Oh my god.
Oh. Bubble. Can't help but do a little
jiggle.
Oh,
there's two. Ah!
Ow.
For God's sake. Round seven. How many points did I get? 11,580.
Right.
Nice. Go on, Baz.
If I don't beat him now,
mm-hmm.
I'm never going to live this down.
No.
He'll beat me, I know he will, but I didn't do very good then.
But he didn't beat me.
Yeah, because you killed him. I didn't get as many points
right.
as you, but I got to a higher level than you, though.
But he still didn't beat me, though.
Yeah. And you.
Oh, no.
Why are you so scared then?
Because I care so greatly about the game.
She cares greatly about this challenge.
I really panic. Getting serious now, round five. Less talking.
He's already beat us. He's already beat us. 13,930.
Nice.
He's already beat us.
Is that because he was eyes?
Kill him.
Are you sure that's a banana? Oh.
Oh, he's angry.
Oh, wow.
He's very angry.
I'm not surprised you blew up all his mates. Panic rock. Oh, there's loads of
them. Oh. Oh, my God, that looks
oh,
dangerous.
Oh, no. Oh. Oh, they're all after you. Oh my gosh, how are you going to do this? Go on.
It is now getting dangerous.
Oh.
Well, he's peed off.
Go on.
Oh, oh. God.
What does that mean?
Another extra man.
Yeah. He's gonna go! He's gonna go! He's gonna go! Go! Go on, you'll get him now. You're gonna time it. Oh, oh no. Oh no.
He's dead.
He's still beat us there.
Not bad. Not bad.
There you go, Dig Dug. Yeah. Josh, I beat you. Fair and square. Put it there.
I still beat you at
Gallagher. You are well and truly beaten.
I still beat you at Gallagher.
Yeah.
Right, 6 months later, in 1982, Universal released an arcade game called Mr. Do. I got it right this time, Mr.
Yay.
Do. Now, I'm not going to go bash on about its similarities to Dig Dug.
Did get that right.
Got one right.
Yeah, I got the name wrong. That comes later. But you can't help but notice there is more than just a passing resemblance between these two.
Mm-hmm, more. In Mr. Do, the objective of the game is to score as many points as possible by, you guessed it,
digging through the dirt,
making tunnels, and collecting cherries. You play Mr. Do, a circus clown, or if you are playing the Japanese version, a snowman who is chased by a bunch of creeps.
Yeah.
And they are really are called creeps. Yeah. You are a bunch of red monsters.
Now, before we go on, Izzy has got a bit of a clown fetish. No, not fetish.
Fetish?
what does fetish mean?
I'll tell you later off camera. No. You don't like things. No, what's the word? Not fetish.
I think it's the complete opposite. Phobia, yeah. Baz. Phobia.
What was it?
Phobia. Does fetish mean by any chance, like, you love it? You love them?
Yeah, let's just go with that, yeah.
Yeah. So Isabel's got a phobia of clowns. But I've said to her, it's not Pennywise. He's not a nasty clown.
He's a nice.
He just wanders
around. He doesn't hide in a drain with a bit with a bone. Yeah, to say, here you go.
Yeah, let's not go there.
Yeah, he doesn't float. He doesn't have a red balloon. So,
I did play it a little bit. Yeah. Mr. Do has to collect all the cherries in a level that are in bunches of 8.
Yeah.
I think. And he's armed with nothing more than a ball. Poor Mr. Do. So, but however, it's a bouncing ball with special abilities.
But it never goes the way you want it to.
No. that's a special ability. He can also drop apples onto the creeps to kill them as well.
It's like Dig Dug.
Yeah. But however, once the ball is chucked, it kind of bounces around and it kills a creep. And then it can take a few seconds until it's available to be thrown again.
Could happen.
No, it could not happen. I mean, no. How often can you be caught in a situation where the only thing you have to fight a potentially dangerous monster is a ball? That's just silly. Name me a scenario where somebody uses a ball against a monster. So you can't. I win.
No. No, I haven't got a clue. Actually, do you know what? Predator 2.
What?
Predator 2. When Bill Paxton's character Lambert faces off against a predator in the subway,
yeah,
and he runs out of ammo, and he just slings his golf ball at the predator.
That's nonsense, throwing a ball at the predator. I mean, yeah, come on, where's that going to get him? I'll tell you where it got him.
It was the effort.
I'll tell you where it got him. It got him dead. He ended up being killed, didn't he, by throwing a golf ball at a predator.
Yeah.
Dad.
What?
Want some candy?
I'm getting too old for this.
Anyway, where were we? Yes, so Mr. Do can push apples off ledges to drop onto the creeps to kill them, which earns you bonus points. Sounds kind of familiar.
It does.
Yeah. Each time the score passes 5,000 points, an alpha monster appears and a letter from the word extra
appears
on the screen.
They escort him around,
doesn't
they?
Yeah. And once all the letters are collected, an extra life is awarded.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So, digging through the dirt, killing underground monsters. It's pretty much what you're doing in both games. Yeah. Sounds like some skullduggery is going on here. So let's take a look at Mr. Do.
Let's look at Mr. Do. Josh is going first. Go on, Josh. Let's see how good you are at Mr. Do. Don't rage quit this time.
No.
He's not been practicing, honestly. Isabel's probably starting to feel a bit nervous now because there's a clown on the screen.
I really don't. Yeah. You told me
he's a nice clown. He's not
so
Pennywise.
Okay. That's all right then.
Oh, God, kill yourself!
Oh dear.
Don't get angry. It's just a game, Josh. So
it's
very similar to Dig Dug in
the guy, it bounced off the monster and came back to me. How does that work?
We'll check that when we look at the footage,
actually. Yeah.
Yeah, so you're tunnelling through dirt and there are monsters and you're throwing balls at them.
Right.
Let's not go there again.
So it's similar in a way, but...
Yeah. Do you know what I love this game? There's so many...
Boom. Oh, for God's sake.
There's so many versions of this on all the consoles. Isabel's go.
Okay. Oh, I'm being handed the controller.
Don't be afraid. He's just a clown.
I'm not looking at him, which I probably should be.
You ever played this before?
No.
Never?
No. So, I don't... The only thing that I like better about... Ooh, oh, my gosh.
Dangerous.
Dig Dug is that... The ball takes ages to come back round, doesn't it?
I know that. When you're in trouble,
yeah, it does.
The monster's coming, you're like, oh, where's my ball?
And that's got to be by design, hasn't it? It's got to be.
You have to time it right.
You've got your weapon, you've got to use it
very, done it again.
Very carefully.
See, I'm no good at this.
No.
This is awful.
So, yeah, once you fire that ball, you've got a few seconds where you're vulnerable. Use the apple.
Oh, no. Oh, I got him. Nice.
I've not played this for a long time, to be honest.
I'm
probably not going to be much better, but...
Nice.
Thanks. No! I don't know what that was. Oh. It's...
Right, let's have a go.
Yeah, I think you're going to be a lot better than I am at this.
Right. Long time no play. Now I make a beeline.
Okay.
For the apple.
Do you have a
for the cake?
A strategy.
This controller.
It's awful.
Isn't it? Nice, baby controller.
It does not play. It doesn't play very nice with this controller.
It's baby controller.
Yeah, see, I can't get into where I want it to go.
No.
At all.
Go on.
Yes. Well, they're stupid.
I was better at this when we weren't actually filming this. Yay.
Right, you're such a pro.
Oh, it's been a while.
What a pro. Oh, yes.
Why are you such a pro?
This is his era.
I was brought up on this sort of thing.
Yeah. Era? It's not your era.
An era is what you dry clothes on.
Yeah, I thought so. Oh, no. Ooh. Oh.
It's tough, this is, you know. I think I do find Dig Dug easier.
Yeah.
So do I. I prefer Ding Dong, just because it's easier. Oh, yes. Nice shot!
Oh, ah.
You didn't get to go to the
tip. So, yeah, if you light up all those extra letters, you do get...
Extra.
An extra man, yeah.
So what do the cherries just give you extra points, don't they?
The cherries, you can clear a level by getting all the cherries.
Oh, so basically. It's kind of like Pac-Man.
Yeah, you clear all the cherries and that's your level done.
There is a lot of guys right now.
There's a lot of stuff going on, isn't there?
Kind of glad I didn't get to this level. Oh, it's very much like Pac-Man now.
Uh-oh, I'm without ball.
Oh, you ran out of room.
Uh-oh.
You're such a pro. Oh, my God.
Oh,
you're such a pro.
Very intense. Oh.
You're kidding me. I didn't even get to the bit where he pushes the apple along and says, well done, we're going to have another go, hang on.
Nice. Oh.
Ooh,
that was insanely quick.
So yeah. Suddenly accelerate. That's not fair.
Don't throw the controller.
I know you did.
Yes. Level 3. Oh, there's an R.
Come here, Mr. R. Oh!
Oh!
See, the ball never goes...
The way you want it to.
Where you want it to.
Oh. I get way too stressed out when you play these games. I hate things chasing you.
Well, you get an R and then T.
Yes. Oh.
Oh my God, you got those cherries again.
Yeah. I love how you've gone completely silent now.
Oh my God.
Oh.
This game is so difficult. It's just brilliant. I love it. So then, we've played both games. Now, I'm going to be totally and brutally honest here. Which game ripped off the other?
Well, Dig Dug did come first, and Mr. Do came 6 months later. It can only be the one, really, can't it?
Well,
yeah, but it's very possible, indeed, that Dig Dug inspired the team at Universal, let's be honest.
Inspired, that's a good way of putting it.
No, inspired is too polite, really.
I think so, yeah.
It's absolutely blatantly a damn rip-off.
No, this was not Universal's first, shall we say, rip-off of somebody else's game. They did it before with Taito's Space Invaders. They released an absolute blatant rip-off of it, called Cosmic Monsters. Have a look at that. There it is. And they also did a game called Ladybug, which has more than a passing resemblance to Pac-Man.
But to be honest, there is no doubt that both games are classic and they are brilliant.
They are.
Both feature wonderful colour graphics, sounds that are instantly recognisable, and great little 8-bit tunes that take you back to the golden days of the 80s arcades.
Yeah, they
and
do
it worked
indeed.
With you, didn't it?
Yeah, as soon as you hear one of those tunes, it's like an earworm. That's going to be in your head for the rest of the day.
And it will be.
You know, you'll be going... All day. I can't believe it. Okay, so which one is better? Now, Namco is a very well-respected developer and very well-known into this day for their games. And not many people know who Universal were as a game developer. Most people think it's a film studio, which it is. And I don't think there's a link between Universal Games and Universal, the film studio. No. I did look, but I couldn't find
them. So they obviously copied Universal Film Studios as well?
Well, I don't know. They just called themselves Universal.
So they copied them as well?
We will never know.
Dig Dug had much greater marketing and push because it had the once almighty Atari distributing it throughout the US and overseas. Yeah. And I certainly remember seeing more Dig Dug machines than Mr. Doom machines back in the day. So I think the marketing was key, really.
That might be so. Yeah. But did you know Mr. Do, the clown, is based on the Universal Company logo used in the 1970s?
It was, that's right. Yeah.
And did you know that if you dig out the dirt from all around the sides of a cherry, Mr. Do, it turns into a rose.
The cherry turns into a rose.
Really?
I didn't know that. We didn't know that. We're going to have a look at
that. Oh.
So, moving on.
Yeah.
Which was better?
Wow.
Go on, go first. Think about both games.
I hate Mr. Do.
That's a strong thing
to say. That's a very strong thing to say.
I don't like it. Okay. I don't like rip-offs. I hate that company that copied Nerf. I hate people that rip off other companies because, no. I hate Lego. I love Lego. But I hate that company that ripped off Lego. I forgot Mega Bloks, whatever it's called. Hmm. I hate all things that rip off other things.
Okay, so you hate all rip-off things. But taking it as a game...
I don't like it, no. Because I just don't like the way he throws the ball and then it doesn't come back to you the way you want it to. And then you're running and then they're faster than you and then you turn around and throw the ball but it doesn't come back to you because it's still bouncing around the whole maze doing absolutely nothing.
Okay, take a breath. So, you prefer Dig Dug. And breathe. So you prefer Dig Dug?
Yeah.
Yes. Why do you prefer Dig Dug?
Because I've been playing it since I was 4 and I just like it. I prefer it better.
There you go. Izzy.
Okay.
Which you prefer?
And it was tense.
I would probably have to say the same. I prefer Dig
Dug.
One, because it's just, I feel like it's easier to play.
Yeah.
Two.
That's the only reason we like it better.
It's easier. So much easier to control, like the whole ball situation, like Josh said, where it just...
You throw it and it's like...
It just seemed a bit messy. They just seemed like there was too much going on, where Dig Dug is just nice and simple. You know what you're doing. Yeah. You know what kills them. And then that's it. You're sorted.
Okay.
So
what do you think?
I am going to go with...
Old man.
You did call me old man, didn't you?
I didn't.
I'm going to have words. I'm going to go with Mr. Do.
No!
Yes. When I look at both games, I love them both dearly.
Okay.
I love Dig Dug. I think Dig Dug's a brilliant game. I love the concept. I love the, you know, the pumping up of the monsters and great. Mr. Do, there is more... I don't know. See, I think, personally, in my honest opinion, there's more strategy involved. There's a lot more monsters legging it around.
True.
The whole thing with extra and making that word extra at the top of the screen.
Yeah.
It's a great game. Yes, the ball disappearing for seconds on end and leaving vulnerable is strategy. It forces you to use the apples.
That's true.
I think it's more. There's more depth to it.
Yeah, it makes.
I do think there's more depth to Mr. Do.
It's better decision making, isn't it? You've got to really think about
it. Harder.
That's right. It is harder. Yeah, and I like that. And I remember looking back when we had Commodore 64s and stuff like that. There were versions of Mr. Do for the Commodore 64, and I always wanted to play it. I loved it. I love them both, but I'm gonna go with Mr. Do. For me,
you're not a dad anymore.
No, that's fair enough. Harsh. We're allowed opinions.
It's, yeah, it is the better game, but I love them both. So
good.
For me, Mr. Do. So it's there 2 for Dig Dug and 1 for Mr. Do.
Dig Dug
so
wins.
Dig Dug wins.
Ah,
Dig Dug is...
Team Dig Dug.
But let us know what you prefer.
Yeah, which one's
better? In the comments.
Yeah, good point. Yeah, do you prefer Mr. Do? Do you prefer Dig Dug? Or do you really not care? In which case, you shouldn't be watching us.
Yes.
But we do appreciate you watching us.
We do, yeah.
So.
Yes, what are we talking about next time?
Fortnite.
Never gonna happen, Josh. So.
What are we looking at next, Izzy?
Shall I reveal?
Yeah.
We're going to do Capcom's Ghosts and Goblins.
Ooh, yes, no.
Yeah.
One of the toughest
games.
It's so hard.
It's ridiculous.
I don't like it.
Compare it to a bloody big diamond.
I don't like it.
Solid.
I don't like it. It's too hard.
So, Ghosts and Ghouls and Ghosts and Goblins are two of Capcom's most famous games.
Yeah.
And they are available on almost every console, every platform.
Yeah.
And they are very much loved, although they are very, very, very,
very
hard.
Very.
So, yes, join us next time when we'll be looking at the history of Ghosts and Goblins. I'm really looking forward to that, actually.
Yeah.
It is tough. You'll probably rage quit within 5 minutes.
He'll rage quit.
Yeah.
I'll probably cry.
I'll just
and
walk
Barry
away.
Will be good at it.
I'll just walk off and leave the camera running. Thank you so much for joining us once again. It's great to have you with us. And we will see you again soon. So please take care.
Bye!
See you soon. Bye!
My snuggly socks are so comfortable!
They look very comfortable.
They're damp. What have you been treading in?
How are they damp?
Spinning.
Okay.
There we go.
Don't move. You know we're still videoing, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
What are we doing?
I've just got a beautiful outtake.